Am I audible? Morning, everyone. So I hope you guys are enjoying in quarantine period. So basically, so today I'm going to speak about recon, means reconnaissance. So if you are a good bug hunter professional, means cyber security professional, then you must know what is recon. So this is the basic overview kind of session. So it will mostly helpful for students. So let me know if you guys have what kind of understanding you have about recon. You can give your inputs, right? I guess, okay. YouTube chat is listening. Okay. Let me tell you. Okay. So meanwhile, session. If you have any questions or query, you can write it down and ask me after session. So we will means try to resolve them. Okay. So and guys, make sure you should open your notepad. So whenever I say some important things, you can write down and just try it at your own, right? Okay. So first thing is, what is reconnaissance? So everywhere you heard about recon, like recon is the key to success in bug bounty. Recon is a key to means success in penetration and means everywhere, wherever cybersecurity comes in a picture. So but how means recon is important, how you should approach the target. So I am going to talk about that. So everyone tell about recon, reconnaissance, but no one means tell about where to apply, means how to means target particular target with particular technology. So we are going to target that thing. You all must know about all the tools and things, but why we need to use that, how to use that, that we will learn here. Okay. So recon is an important step in exploring an area to steal confidential information. Okay, so it is just exploring. It's a phase of information gathering. So you have to means find out all the assets, all the infrastructure of the particular target. If suppose I am giving you a target called hackerone.com, so you have to find out all the means subdomains of that, all the assets, all the means JavaScript files, all the repositories. Everything which means connected to that target, all the employees information, all the social accounts of them, everything. So you will come up with all the combination of the information, and then you will analyze that this thing I have to means trigger, this means attack I have to launch, these are the means loopholes in this system, and this is how I approach the means vulnerability analysis. So vulnerability analysis is a second part. So in that part you will means go for OWASP top 10 vulnerabilities and everything, logical findings and all. But first your reconnaissance should be means perfect. So why reconnaissance? So basically, as I said, in penetration testing, so if you in what happen in if you are working in a means company, so there is means limited scope of engagement. So you have to means they give you some scope, you have to means go there, or you can remotely work and you have to paint test their applications and means infrastructure like that. In bug bounty hunting, the scenario is something different. They give you means the list of the all the means asset, everything, infrastructure, which is in scope, which is out of scope, and you have to start hunting. So what you should look, how you may start hunting over there. So both the scenario you need means some business understanding also, that what kind of business is going on, means how you means approach the means particular application, what application is doing, why user is using that application. You need means proper mindset of that thing. So we are going to talk about that mindset today. So because in technology you will find everything on Google, you will means get all the tools, you will get everything on Google, or means videos, everything. But the mindset you have to develop by your own, you will learn it by your means experience. So that's the thing we are going to talk about. So means if you means the, targeting a network, then what should be your means goal? To means what should be you discover? So basically you will discover IP addresses or hosts, accessible ports or means underlying applications over there. If you find out applications, then you should find out operating system type and what other means asset, subdomain information and vulnerable components like that. So we are going deep into that. Okay. So now types of reconnaissance. So there are two kind of reconnaissance are there. First is active reconnaissance and the second one is passive reconnaissance. So now what is the difference between this active and passive thing? So active reconnaissance is a reconnaissance where intruder directly engage with the particular target. So okay, so if I give a hacker one as a target, right? So you are means directly put that target into your burp suite or means whatever means tool you are using or means whatever the way you are targeting to the application. So you will means directly fuzz into that application, you will directly crawl that application and you will start hunting your means OWASP opt and vulnerability and everything. So that is active reconnaissance, which will make noise, which will create noise on that particular target. And your means fingerprinting, footprinting, everything will be stored in their logs file. So that is called active reconnaissance. It will comes in picture when target give you permission to means pen test their network. Then only you can use active reconnaissance. And now what is passive reconnaissance? Now passive reconnaissance is a means, kind of thing where there are many third party services are available which have already some leaked information about the particular target, some employee already hacked account information, everything means website sitemap, everything are stored already. So you can go there, means find out there, you can search about subdomains from means that database kind of things, and you will come up with certain information. That is passive reconnaissance. So we are going further into this. So I'm going to tell about scripts are available in GitHub for means perform reconnaissance. So first phase is information gathering. So ab information gathering mein mostly hum kya karenge? So this is the question. So mostly in general people are doing subdomain enumeration, they are means doing directory enumeration, but there are other things are also there which means people miss, and sometimes very critical bugs in means bug crowd or hacker one like P1, P2, P3 category bugs are come up with those means passive recon techniques. So we are going to talk about this. Okay. So first is who is information. So suppose आप hackerone.com, so what you will do, आप मतलब देखोगे कि ये कहाँ से है रजिस्टर, इसका क्या क्या means वहाँ firewall लगा है क्या है, what are the things behind that, who is the means register of this website, किस कौन इसको on करता है, वो सारी information आप हुई से देख सकते हो कि इसका server कहाँ पे located है, सारी चीजें मतलब geographical information तो आप वहाँ से ले सकते हो. फिर आता है IP range. So this is the means I'll show you something. Sorry. Okay, I'll show you some who is information thing, that how it is going to work, what kind of information you can find there. I hope you can see my browser. Okay, so this is who is domain tool.
Ashish, let's find out. Still at your PPT screen, you can't see your browser.
Okay, wait. I have to share my desktop, I guess.
Yes.
Wait for a minute, guys. Are you able to see my screen?
Yeah, we can see your browser window.
Okay, that's good. So my internet is little bit slow, so that's the issue. It will take time. Meanwhile, we are look for another means website. This is IP range. So you can find out IP range of the particular target, right? So if I give you hacker1.com, then you must have to know that what kind of means, what is the range of this particular network? What others means asset are there? So you need to find out the range of that. So this is the another website to find out. So here I put already hacker1.com. So it will give all the IP ranges. See, these are the IP ranges, and it is Cloudflare. So basically, it is means TCP web by Cloudflare. So it is firewall. So this is not loading. So you can try it at your own. Okay, इसमें कोई मतलब कुछ है नहीं. आप यहाँ पे वेबसाइट का नाम डालोगे तो उसकी सारी इंफॉर्मेशन आ जाएगी. आप मतलब देख सकते हो कि क्या क्या है. So that's the thing. So this is the IP info. Okay. So the next thing is. This subdomain S3 buckets and directory info will come this to later. So this is social account thing and OS int. So you must know about open source intelligence, right? So what is OS int thing? So basically, in a social account, when you means gather information about social accounts, then you should means know how many employees are there, means which employee are active on internet, which employee are using social account, which of them can be easily hacked by social engineering technique. So this is comes into that. So you can find out employee information on LinkedIn, or this is OS in framework. You can find out all the information like username, information from here, email addresses from here. These are the several tools are listed here, which are standard tools. You can use them to means find out and gather information about the particular target. So this is who is record subdomains. The subdomain, you can try this kind of, these all the tools to find out all the subdomains. Okay, so this is standard methods. So everything will be available here. So by using them, these, you can means find out all the information about the particular target and that social account. So by using that, you can means hack into means at level means at a means very good level into means that particular organization. You will get means if you means suppose there is a manager of a company who has means very big password of any social account, and you are successfully means able to social engineer him and find out the password, and the password will be same to means their employee portal, then you can easily means get into their employee portal, right? So this kind of things you can means do. You have to perform means reconnaissance. So the next thing is component information. So what is component? Now you can means find out component information in webanalyzer.com. So here you can means this is webanalyzer.com. See, so sorry, look for website, right? Look for hacker1.com. hacker1.com. So it will comes up. Okay. So it want me to register into their website, but you can register into it and find out means what kind of things it is using. So I have already installed its plugin. You can install its Chrome plugin. So this is it here, Web Analyzer. So see here, you can see Google Analytics. They have installed. They are using Nuxt and Vue JavaScript frameworks. This Amazon S3 buckets thing. They use Node.js as a programming language. Means kind of Node.js framework basically. They have used CloudFront, means Amazon CloudFront, payment processor Stripe 3. So everything you will find out here. And now what, why this is important in Recon? So once you means, see, there are, so this is D3. D3 is a JavaScript chart. So this is, they are using this library. They have used the cloud CDN, and so means they are protected by Cloudflare. So this is the thing. This website, see. So as you get versions and means kind of software or library kind of exploit. So you can check that. You can use means search exploit on Kali Linux to means find out which CV is there for particular platform. If you, there is a outdated version of Apache means perform RC vulnerability over there, and many other things are there that you can find out on Google, right? So that's why this component enumeration is very important. So now let's move to the subdomain S3 buckets and directory info. Okay. So subdomain enumeration. So I have put several tools to find out subdomain. So let me explain why subdomain enumeration is important. So first thing, there is a website called let's suppose example google.com, right? Now Google has so many services. Google has Alphabet, right? So Google has their chat service, message service, video service, they have Picasa, everything. So they have so many subdomains are there. So what happened? Now there are different subdomains as different services, and there are different APIs are there. So you need to dig into it and once find out what are the critical functionalities are there, what you can do to get into that, and what you can means how you can means dump your vulnerability assessment on particular subdomain. So first thing, you need to enumerate all the subdomains of the particular target. So there are several tools are available. Some of the those are means active, and some of means those are passive reconnaissance tools. So basically what happened, if you the standard tool is Aquaton, MS, Dominate. So these are the tools which you can enumerate all the subdomains of the particular target. There are means other assets called sensi.io is a website, crt.sh. So this website will help you to means find out their subdomain from their certificates and everything. So we will see means some of the tools which are installed in my means machine, Kali machine, and you can go for all. You can try these all the means tools. So we will means in next step we'll do what do after the getting all the subdomains. Okay. So first we use this asset finder. Okay. So let me share you. Are you able to see my Kali machine, guys?
Yes, we can see.
Okay. So first thing we are going to use is asset finder. Okay, asset finder is very good means passive reconnaissance tool to enumerate all the subdomains. So we are starting with that. You have to put this subs only and your domain name, okay, your target name. So once you hit enter, you will get to know, see, all the subdomains of the particular target. So now you have data of all the means. We will take one tool. So for your means understanding, you can use all the tool and you can find out the difference on the Google or internet. You can find out. But we are using simple tools, okay, to do that. So there is another tool called Sublister, which can you can use that too. You can MS, you can use Aquaton. So Aquaton is also there. So how to use Aquaton? Aquaton Discover. The Discover is a means in Aquaton, which means very first time when you means enumerate any target, then you have to run this command. You need to put this domain and you have to put like google.com. Google.com. You can put threads too, that how many threads you want to. Suppose 25. Okay. So it will start. See. So it will means collect information from thread cloud, Sensi, Soda, passive reconnaissance websites, public website, public database. So So it will comes up with all the gathered information. So you will have a bunch of subdomains. Some of them are active, some of them are inactive. So now second step is you have to find out. You have to manually find out, or means there are certain tools and scripts are available to find out which domains are live and which are means inactive. Okay. So for that you can use HTTP probe. You can write it down. Okay. I'm not going to use everything because of my internet issue. So you can means write it down HTTP probe. So it is the tool to calculate HTTP resource pool. Okay. So see all like all these subdomains, then store it into any TXT file. And if you run it with HTTP probe, then you will find out all the status code like 301, 200, okay. So you can get that these are the reachable websites and these are inactive, okay. Then after you have to means differentiate those both, and means you have to run your further information gathering on means active targets, okay. So let's suppose I'll show you some of two other tools which are means available here. Sublister is there, okay. So sublister Python 3 skip sublister, okay, minus D, you have to give it as a command and you will put google.com, okay. And now what happened, again it will give you means list of certain, it will check here Baidu, Yahoo, Google, Bing, everywhere, and must find comes up with all the subdomains of google.com. Now you have to, I'll tell you one another thing, okay, sorry. So if you want to scan by using particular ports, then you can do it by this sublister. So you can check P80, so every subdomain comes with port 80 open, 8080, so 443, which is HTTPS. So you will get to know, okay, where is underlying applications are running, okay. So you have to perform this kind of thing. And suppose if you know there are vulnerable ports are there, like 1009, like 8000. So this 800 is a Java Salifier, which is used to connect with wire protocol on Java. So there is RC vulnerability. So you can find it out by using this. So by like this you record. So I am not performing everything. I'm just showing you. You can try it later on. Okay. So I'll show you I give you all the list tools. Okay. So there are more assets like Sensi.io. So you use Sensi.io. Wait. I have to share another screen. It is possible to share my screen.
If you stop the screen share and click on share again, you will get bunch of options. There you'll see desktop on desktop.
Right. Wait, I am getting only screen. Okay, my screen. Are you able to view my screen, guys?
Yes, we are seeing the PPT.
Okay. Now you can see my full screen.
Yes.
Okay. Give me some time. So another thing is Sensi. So we will look at Sensi. Is a website. So here you can find out all the information about the particular target. So if you put the IP address of a target here, then you will able to means see like this is the IP address, okay. So So you can see all the ports here, which ports is open, which version is they are using, and who is information to. So you can see all the information is listed here. Okay. So there is another website called Sodan. Okay, you can use it to enumerate your thing. Sodan.io. So what happened, Sodan has their own port scanner, so which is much faster than Nmap. So they have means list a bunch of websites. If you open any website and if you means install Sodan extension, like I have installed here, so you can see the all the information, public IP, which ports are open here and everything. And if you click on view host detail, you can find out all the detail about that particular host, which server is running there, which organization, which ISP, everything. Okay, so use this, it will be very beneficial. You can means find out all the default ports and other informations too. Okay, so if you want to find out some specific server information and everything, then there are you can search for a cheat sheet of this Sodan. You can find out on the internet that you can use that to search further. So let's suppose we can find out this Jenkins instance. How many Jenkins instances are there? So you can find out. See, these many means Jenkins servers are available there. There is top in China, United States. So let's click on United States. So I need to log in into it. Okay, see, now you can see all the results here of Jenkins in country US. Okay, so these are the means dork you have to put. This is Sodan dorks. Okay, so this is the Linode server, this is the Amazon. If you click on this, you can find out means particular IP address or on particular means the target. So this is how you can means recon further. If you get means Jenkins or any misconfigured Jenkins, then you can achieve RCE on that server by creating your account on that. You will find out write up of this kind of vulnerabilities on Google. Okay, so this is, I'm just showing you way means what you should look. Okay, so you can see here what kind of technology they have used. They have used Java, so mostly in Java deserialization vulnerabilities are there. You can see that you can just try to find out them. If they have used JBoss, then you can use means you can means if older version of JBoss are there, then you can means find out some CL upload vulnerabilities there by using means JaxBoss. JaxBoss is a tool, you can write it down. You can use it, you can means make use it on means Java website mostly, where is a JMX servlet are there, these kind of things are there. So you have to look into means other resources in internet, you will means get to know how to use that tool. Okay. So this is Google Cloud vendor which has Jenkins running. That version is 2.7.4, so like that. So this subdomain enumeration part, there is another website called View DNS information. So you can find out DNS information. View DNS information. Okay. So here all the means basic tools are available. You can means see reverse IP lookup, reverse noise lookup, IP history, DNS report, IP location finder, everything you can means do from here. You can run this test your own and you can find out means what this, how this will be helpful in your recon. Okay, you should try this too. Okay, this is the thing. Another thing is S3 bucket and data tree enumeration. Now this is very important part. Now once you have a bunch of subdomains, like I have I have get subdomains of something like this is Starbucks. Okay, there are certain websites which I have done this one. So this is Tesla.com. Okay, I have done this, this basic subdomain enumeration of that particular target. Tesla. Okay, so how you can approach that? So these are some basic live URLs of the Tesla.com. So you have to find it using HTTP probe, or there is one script called Reci. You can write it down, R-E-C-C-E, okay, Reci, which is means specially designed to means find out live subdomain from a text file. Okay, so you need to put text file and run it into Reci. You can search it on GitHub. Okay, you will find that. So in basic things, we are not going much into deep. Okay, you can do it by your own. So these are the Tesla.com. Now let's take this one URL, like billing Tesla.com. Okay, so this is billing Tesla.com. Now what should I do? What should I look for into it? So I need to search, as I told you, I need to search for components, which technology they have used, what, how many directories are there. So you have to find out that. Like we put this, see, it is redirected to another means website. Steve, it is, I guess it is owned by Tesla. So you need to find out by who is and means other thing. So this is, here you can see this is Tesla. So this domain is also owned by Tesla. So earpods, purple 3 and 80 are open. Okay, so this is the thing. Now you can find out which framework they have used. They have used AngularJS 1.2.13. okay, so you can find out the expert for this version, and you can use it into means your pen testing. You know, when you means fire up burp and means try to means explore the particular target, then you can means use those specific string and means vulnerability to vulnerability means payload to means put into that, and means you can get into the system. Means you can means particularly exploit the vulnerability. Okay, this is how you can look for the vulnerabilities. So now second thing, I need to find out which directories are there and how it is means structured. So there are mostly sitemaps are available in certain website, but certain have doesn't. So you need to find it out manually. So there are certain tools for that. So there is bucket, there is a deer search Python tool which you must know about. You can use this to means find enumerate directories of particular target subdomain. This is DIRB. It is you can use it to means same again brute force means directories as per your means word list. Okay, and this is S3 bucket enumeration. Now S3 buckets enumeration is a kind of thing which is means owned by Amazon AWS. If you have AWS CLI in your Kali machine installed, and if you find out a target which has means some functionalities, some files are there on AWS, then you can means try to find out misconfigured buckets. Means how you can look find out that bucket is misconfigured. So once you hit the subdomain, then you will find out an XML metadata in a response in a browser. It comes up with a means XML data which comes up with certain keys and all. So maybe it can be vulnerable. So you have to means fire up your AWS CLI, and means you can further attack on that particular subdomain. You can upload your SQL, or means upload your text file, or means whatever you want to do. Okay, so that's the thing. This is how you can means take advantage of misconfigured S3 buckets. You can find many reports on HackerOne of S3 buckets, so you can get to know about this. These are the tools to find out that. So this is DIRB. So let's use it. Let's try. Wait a minute. So I'm having issue with my machine, and so but still we are going to try. Okay, so I have suppose DIRB is pre-installed, and you can use suppose google.com. Yes. google.com. okay, and if you enter, then it will be what means this is the it is error connecting to us because of my internet connection. But once you miss
you missed the URL. It's 410W.
Oops, sorry. Okay, so this is calculating the, okay, thanks for letting me know. So this is how it means work. It will means use this common text file, a word list. So you can use your own means. You can find out on SAC list. Please write SAC list. SAC list has a means so many word list of particular technologies like Apache, IIS, everything. So this is how you can means find out all the directories. So this is like that. Now let's move to another. So what I am talking, the my main thing, that how you means should approach the subdomain. So if you find out an IIS server on the particular particular subdomain, right, then if whenever you are fuzzing that with directory enumeration or means anything, then you should use the means standard documentation of IIS directories. So it might more possibility to means get access of the particular directories. You will get more 200 okay responses, right? But if you put Apache Apache directory over there, then you won't get anything. So you need to miss sharp and understanding that we what technology target is using, what I should miss approach. If machine is Windows and you are trying miss directory list of Unix, then it won't work. Okay, so you need to miss understanding that how what should I use. Okay, so this is the thing. Then the most important thing is GitHub. So GitHub is means extremely helpful to finding sensitive information regarding the targets. So you can find out mostly access keys, password, open endings, S3 buckets, backup files, anything. You can find out, sometimes you can find out some FTP server username, password, and many other things. Okay. So these are available on public GitHub repository. Now what happened? Very first I told you to miss recon for the user, means users. So there are means some certain developer which they have made their means GitHub profile public. So whenever they miss write code or commit code, then everything can be viewed by public. So whenever you search for the GitHub for the particular company information, then you can find out many code repositories containing very sensitive information about the particular target. Sometimes you get a password, API keys, APIs, many things which you usually don't come up in a recon by means these automated tools. So you can use this GitRope, GitLibs, these two means standard tools to use for means GitHub. We don't have much time, so otherwise I show you, but you can find out in means YouTube on their repository. You can find it out. Okay, you can easily use these tools. So this is manual GitHub recon. We'll do this. So if you put company and password name in the GitHub, then you will miss get to know other information. See, okay. Take a time, guys. Okay. Let's suppose we take this company name, put password. This is a manual record. Okay. Same you can use by using GitHub, but GitHub comes up with a particular means repository which comes up which has a Tesla means names. So one repository found Tesla password. There are 199k ports are available for Tesla. See here you can see these are the all the public. These are some ports are related to Tesla, means some are pointing to Tesla or some are not. Some are means vendor, some are means author. So you need to means find where is Tesla to look at the scope of the means particular engagement. So you can work like that. So by using this, you can find out many sensitive information, exposure means vulnerability. You can use this much, this many means work. You can hit these many docs into GitHub. Okay, you can find out company secret, credentials, token, config, key, pass, login, everything. You can find out if a website is in Java, then you can search for JDBC database. So you will get the string of JDBC database connection URL and everything. Okay, so now most important part is JS file and web archive for recon. So you need to find look into JS files too. So in JavaScript file, sometimes what happen, if you find out some internal domain or means the domain which is not mostly used, so the developer used to means put some API keys or means direct login information or means direct some kind of logic which can be means altered by malicious attacker which are available in this JavaScript file. You should run, you should find out all the JS files. There are certain tools are JS parser, link finder, these Webpack URLs and many more. So you can find out other things. These Webpack URLs is for web archive data. You can find out other deprecated URLs and URLs which are day-to-day used by different users from worldwide. You can find out on archive.org. Okay, there is so many things which are archived but still on the website, available, which is not removed from the online their server. So you can use that for vulnerability hunting. Okay, so this is how you can. If I share one of the my experience, there are times when I was sent to one of the big telecom company for their internal audit. So what happened? वहाँ पे मुझे उनका internal CRM tool का audit करना था. So it is standard developed in Java, but when I look for the JavaScript files and do static code review, then I find out some other URLs too, which is pointing to their database. So and many other things like their API keys too, and other login logics, everything are there, and I am able to log in into their login portal, employee login portal, without their consent, without any ID password. And there are certain, I found certain servers are there also, which are open and which have default credentials vulnerability there. So I am able to access their admin panel also. So this is this kind of vulnerability you can able to find using JavaScript files. Okay, so you must look into that. So there are visual recon tools are there, OSN tools are there. So you can use these websites, Visual Sitemapper and many other. This Visual Sitemapper is showing. I don't have much time to show you guys, but Visual Sitemapper. See, you can, this is an example. If you put this lntm.com as a target, then you can find out all the how the all the sitemap of the particular website. See, this is the URL, how those are connected, what are the severity, what are incoming, what are the outgoing. You can check it by at your own. You can use history, everything. Okay, everything is there. So you can put your target here and get the map. So you can do it by your own. Okay, so these are the thing mostly in recon. So there are some automated recon tools are there, like Osmos DS, which is automatically run all the subdomain enumerator, all the HTTP probe things and everything. It will comes up with all the CSP bypasses and everything. It will some they are developers currently working on some XSS things and everything. Other OWASP top 10 vulnerability. So you can use this to, if you have the permission to perform active reconnaissance. There is a lazy recon script is there, which is provided by Namasec. Another is recon, which is also very helpful. But as per my suggestion, you should go manually rather than automatic. Okay. There is another thing called eyewitness. It is, you must know about that. So when you get the bunch of subdomains, then you have to put into eyewitness and stay. It will, what it will do, it will capture all the screenshot of the particular targets given in text file. So you will get all the screenshot of the all the URLs. So you can easily get to know that where is login panel, where is open home page. So you should know what to attack. Okay, so this is open your mind. So use these kind of things while recon. Okay, so there are some Burpsuit plugins and other tools are there. So there is a tool called Wayback Machine. So you can download Wayback Machine script from GitHub too, and there is a Burp extension too. This is, I have already downloaded Burp extension, Wayback Machine. If you put hackerone.com and click on go, it will comes up with all the Wayback URLs, all the directories. So it will very helpful to you to performance recon. You can go to there, means find out directory travels the vulnerability. Sometimes there is upload function. You can achieve RCs and any other vulnerabilities are there. There are many JS files. You can read logics and many things you can perform by doing this. So you should do this while you are recon any target. So there is another thing called Forum Spider, which you can find from GitHub. So what it will do, if you give any URL to this Forum Spider, it will comes up with certain parameters, all the parameters of that particular website or particular URL. So it will easy to fuzz all the parameters and find out, means you can easily find out reflected accesses, sometimes command executions are there. Means you need to find out that if parameter name is URL or means go to URL or send URL, send next, then it must be open redirect vulnerability. You can find out SSR up there. So you have to, it should be trigger in your mind that what should I look into the particular parameter. If a parameter is reflecting in response, then you should try accesses. So this kind of thing in happen in recon. So basically this is Arjun. It is same as means param spider. You can means enumerate all the parameters using this. This is Burp Bounty. It is a tool in Burp Suite extension. You can means edit. It is very means you must know about this. It is very easy. You should put it and it will means show you when you scan anything. It will comes up with means basic vulnerability. Add your payload list into it also to fuzz more. So this is the thing. Please, presentation is Google and other site, as you know, because बहुत late पता चला था मुझे भी ये presentation का. So बस it will tell you about that. So this is the thing. So one thing, okay, I want to tell of the topic after me. I am going to conclude my session. So basically, if you are working in a IT company, right? If you are working in a company as a security engineer, or means you are a student or a bounty hunter, then what is the thing which make you sharp? So it is your mindset, is how you approach the particular thing. You should understand the target. Like if I give you means a website, means as my personal experience, I must means assure that you should have a proper business understanding of the particular website. If I give you Facebook, suppose मैंने आपको Facebook दिया तो आपको पता होना चाहिए कि Facebook is a social networking site, right? तो वहाँ पे means क्या important है, वहाँ पे किस type के vulnerability, किस type के logical flaws allowed होते हैं, okay? So if you are pen testing any school website, तो आपको पता होना चाहिए कि school का business logic क्या है. आप कोई means bank की website कर रहे हो pen test, आप कोई means matrimony site की कर रहे हो, तो वो ऐसे work करता है. Suppose मैट्रिमोनियल साइट की आप कर रहे हो तो उसमें बर्थ रेट वो सब चीजें दिखती है, राइट? उसका बिजनेस ऐसा है कि उसमें बर्थ रेट दिखनी चाहिए यूजर को. बट बैंक का अगर आप कर रहे हो तो उसमें बैंक वाले आपकी बर्थ रेट की इंफॉर्मेशन लेते हैं बट वो दिखा नहीं सकते. सो देयर इज द वल्नरेबिलिटी इन बैंक सिनेरियो बट देयर इज नॉट द वल्नरेबिलिटी इन दैट मैट्रिमोनियल साइट सिनेरियो, राइट? आई होप यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड माय पॉइंट. सो दैट्स द थिंग, यू हैव टू डेवलप योर मींस माइंडसेट that how you must look into the particular application. You should understand the business logic first, business, and then after you should go for the means of software vulnerability and some logical finding. Tools are there. See, technology is there. Technology is means advanced, and technology means update every day. So you will find out many other tools. AI is means progressing. So you will find out any automated tools in future too. But if you have proper mindset, na, then you can means find out more cool bugs. Okay. So if you have any question, you can ask me. If I can help you, I'll definitely help. So thank you. And this is who I am. I am Ashish Patel. I'm a learner basically. I'm an ex cyber security consultant of EY and currently working in one of the Dubai based MNC as a cyber security consultant. And sometimes whenever I am free, I am using part time bug hunting. So if you have any queries, if you want to need, if you want any kind of help or any kind of suggestions, or if you want to give me any suggestions, so if you want to share your knowledge, you can means keep in touch with me here. Okay, so thank you so much everyone.
Yeah, Ashish, just a minute, I'm monitoring the YouTube chat right now. Let's take some questions if our viewers have some questions.
Okay, sure.
So guys, you have some question, you can drop in the YouTube chat. Ashish will try to answer them. So there is one question by Bhart.
Just a minute. I'm monitoring the...
Yeah, Jay, you were saying something? Okay, so one question is from Bhagyesh Doshi. He is asking, can we get your presentation PPT? Yes, definitely. We are going to put this PPT on the Null portal. You can have it from there. Ashish, is there any specific word list that you want to recommend to our viewers?
Yeah, sure, sure, sure. So, guys, basically, अगर ऐसा होता है ना कि मैं अभी मतलब आपको समझा रहा हूँ कि मतलब अगर आपने ये basic recon किया, आपने find out की technology, आपको एक subdomain मिला, test.case.com, okay, उसमें अगर IIS 10 install किया है, तो आप बेसिकली क्या करिए, IIS की ऑफिशियल वेबसाइट पे जाइए, वहाँ पे मीन्स उसके डॉक्यूमेंटेशन में आपको उसके मीन्स मिल जाएंगे, उसके फोल्डर्स, उसके पाथ. सो यू शुड प्रिपेयर योर ओन ऑल वर्ड लिस्ट और यू मस्ट स्टैंडर्ड वर्ड लिस्ट आर फ्रॉम सैक लिस्ट. यू कैन यूज सैक लिस्ट वर्ड लिस्ट टू.
ओके, वन मोर वीक. Yeah, one. Thank you. One more question we have on the Burp Bounty plugin from Jay. He's asking, could you please elaborate more about Burp Bounty plugin?
Okay, it is basically okay. So Burp Bounty मतलब वो हमारे scanner Burp के scanner के साथ काम करता है basically. So if you miss put all the profiles and install this Burp Bounty plugin, then it will be automatically configured with your Burp scanner, and if it will miss fuzz all the parameters by given particular payloads, and if there is a vulnerability, it will trigger and show you in miss warning section that this